Okay guys, in today's class, so till now we have studied the table classification idea of Dobrynian, and after that we have studied the classification idea of Newlands. After that, so we came across the classification idea of father of periodic table, that is Gregor John Mendel. Okay, so all of these three guys tried to classify the elements based on their atomic masses. That is the main reason why John Mendeleev failed. Okay, why his law failed? Because he failed to give us spaces for the isotopes. That was the main reason the Mendeleev table has been rejected. But his success rate was still 90%. 95% success the Mendeleev have got. But due to the even in modern periodic table also, the position of hydrogen is debatable only. Even modern periodic table has also didn't give proper position. It's one of the drawback of modern periodic table, the position of hydrogen. So that is not a matter. But the main thing here, the matter is the position of the isotopes which were discovered in the future. I told you, right? Every element has its isotopes. Isotope is nothing but same atomic number, different masses. So here, different mass and same atomic number. That what happens here? Different masses. Mendeleev tried to classify elements based on the mass. Means hydrogen has three elements which have a masses 1, 2, 3. That means hydrogen itself gets three different slots. If we arrange elements in based on their increasing order of their atomic masses, then what about lithium? So lithium has atomic mass of 3 only. Then what about lithium? The lithium place is going to taken by the one of the isotope of hydrogen. That was the problem this guy has faced. Due to that, his law has been cancelled. So this guy, the person who arranged this modern periodic table, he found that a problem, and he found the solution for that also. How he found the solution? So he observed the atomic structure of an element, and he found that number of protons are never changes during any kind of the condition of an element. He found this, and number of protons gives you the atomic number. Atomic number is nothing but number of protons present in the nucleus of an element. Okay, atomic number is called as protons. Atomic number is equal to number of protons, and he found that protons number will never change. Either they decrease, either they increase during at any condition of the element. So by that, see, he took atomic number as the main base for the arranging table, and he arranged it. Okay, instead of taking atomic mass, he tried to arrange the elements based on their atomic number. See, so every element will have a different atomic number. It is not possible to have elements with same atomic number. We too have isobars. Those are also that is also one of the different disadvantages. Isobars are those whose are going to have a same atomic mass, same mass, but different atomic number. Different atomic number. Same mass they are going to have, a different atomic number you are going to. That doesn't matter here. You are going to have a different atomic number, right? Then that doesn't matter. They may have a same mass, but they are going to be located in a different places of the table. That will not alter. The main idea is to arrange this table is atomic number. You should remember. This is found by a person called as Henry Moseley. Henry Moseley is the person who identified, who arranged all the elements in this manner. The law given by Henry Moseley is called as law of modern periodic table. That's we can see here. Okay, let's see that law of modern periodic table over here. First we'll see the law and then we'll go to the table, how he has arranged, what are the features of this his table and everything we will see. First, what is the law given by him is simple, guys. The chemical properties, physical and chemical properties of an elements, physical and chemical properties of elements are periodic functions of their atomic mass is said by Mendeleev. Instead of mass, this guy said physical and chemical properties of elements are periodic functions of their atomic number. Okay, this is the law. So he used this atomic number concept to arrange the elements. And when he arranged elements using atomic number, increasing order of atomic number, he also found the repetition of physical and chemical properties after certain period. After every eighth element, initially he started getting a repetition of physical and chemical properties for the second period, say 8th period, 16th period, 32nd period, like that. See, if you see that, if you want to see this, see here, hydrogen, then helium, and after these two elements, here lithium he has got. The repetition of the property has taken place. From this point, see here, beryllium 1, if you read this from this point, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Sir, 8th element was showing the repetition. There is a repetition in the properties of first. I had a repetition in the properties of second element. Now, second period. Now I started getting repetition in the properties of the elements in the after 8th element. If you see from here, here also I will get repetition after 8 elements. See, if you count from here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8th element is started showing same properties here. So here lithium, sodium, potassium are light metals and they all have a one valence electron in their outermost shell. They are showing, all of these elements are showing same properties. Here potassium, sodium started showing their similar properties after 8th element. From here if you read, the elements will start showing the repetition in the properties after 16th element. See here, from if you read 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16th element is going to repeat the property here. From here also 16th element will repeat. From here 32nd element will repeat the property. See here 1. So this is the continuation. Actually we have F and D here. From here 1, 2, 3. This is a continuation of this period only. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like this. And if you read this, 32 elements are there. After 32nd, we started. See here, we are when he arranged elements based on the atomic manner, he started getting repetition in the properties in these phases. First, he started getting repetition after 2 elements. Then he started getting a repetition in the properties after 8th elements. Then he started getting repetition in the properties after every 16th element. Then he started getting repetition in the properties of the elements after every 32nd element. So that's why he used the term called as periodic. Periodic means, so there is some events are going to happen in certain periods. After every certain period, something is going to happen. Here what is happening? After every period, we are seeing a repetition in the physical and chemical properties. See, that's why he said that physical and chemical properties of these elements are the periodic functions of their atomic masses. The physical and chemical properties will repeat based on after certain period. This is the law given by Gregor Jan Mendel. Henry Moseley. So only difference is there in Mendeleev and Henry Moseley is Mendeleev used atomic mass here. This guy is using atomic number. And I already told you what is the difference and why does Jan Mendel failed. Because he used atomic mass, right? I told you what is the difference between atomic mass and atomic number. Okay, shall we begin this? Let me erase all of these things. Okay, let's see the futures of his Mendeleev, Henry Moseley's table. Moseley's table. What all are the futures of his table? Let's see that. Okay. Let's see what is his future. So, how he has arranged. We'll see all of them. You keep on copying the things. So that you will get idea. Take a notebook, a notebook and pen, so you will get idea. And this is very interesting one also. See, first you can see here, he arranged elements in a column manner. So how many columns we have? First, he named them also. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth column. Here third column is this one, seventh column, eighth column, so this is ninth column, tenth column, 11th column, 12th column, see 13th, 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th, 18th. So columns totally we have in his table, totally we found 18 columns. Columns means if you start writing number like this means it is column only, right? This is column. If you start writing number in this horizontally means it becomes row. Okay, totally 18 columns and he gave name for the column as a group. You should understand. He called columns are his groups so that we can have 18 groups in his table. So first group, this is group 1, that is let's say G1, this is G2, this is G3, this is G4, this is G5, this is G6, this is G7, this is G8 and so on, this is G18. Okay, 18. Totally we have 18 groups. Okay, next what he did. See here, he also arranged elements in a horizontal manner. See, so like this also. How many? So see here, how many rows we have? First, second, third, this is first row. First row, second row, see here first row has two elements. This second row has 2 plus 6, 8 elements. Third row, fourth row, fifth row, sixth and seventh. See here, you find these two. Actually, this is the continuation. See, say a color you can find out. 57 to 71 is over here. This is continuation of this period only. Here 56, then 57, 58 like this. And this is, you will learn why they have divided like this in your higher classes. This is the continuation of 7th period. Actinoids, here we have divided. This is called F block. It is divided into lanthanoid and actinoid. Lanthanoid and actinoid. Lanthanoids are the continuation of 6th period and actinoids are continuation of the 7th period. Okay. So, how many rows we have found here? Totally 7 rows. This row is a continuation of 6th row and this row is also continuation of 7th row. So, totally how many rows are there here? If you see 1, 2, 3,
four, five, six,
seven. So we found totally seven rows. Totally seven rows in his table. That means he called rows as a period. Why he called rows as a period? So initially he started getting repetition in second period, right? After 2 LMC year, first, second. After second element, he started getting. He called this as a period 1. Because in this period 1, we started finding repetition. After this, he started getting 8th element. He said that this is period 1. Here also we are seeing, after second period also, we are seeing repetition. After third period also, for every period, you see, we are seeing a repetition. That's why he called them as a periods. I hope you understood this much. Okay, now we clear with number of groups and number of rows present in the periodic table. Let's see next some more important interesting points regarding this. Okay, let me erase this. Interesting point we will see. Okay, let's see. Then, so he divided the table into 18 groups and 7 rows. With that, he also divided table into blocks. He also divided his table into 4 blocks. Okay, first block is S block, second is B block, third is D block, and fourth is S block. So you'll also see what is this S, P, D, F blocks in your 11th class. Okay, S block is this one. These two, starting two. In S block, you're going to find first group and second group. Both are combinedly called as S block. So in P block, see here you can find these elements. Let me mark them with this color. See here. This one, 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 this one. So from 3 to 12, all are belongs to D block. Sorry, not P block. So D block, so which involves 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 till 12. All or belongs to D block. He called this as a D block elements. So this total block what we have. This is D block. This is D block. And these two are S block elements. And here from here what we have. From group 13 to this what we have. 18. This he called as a P block element. This is called a, he called these are the P block elements. P block elements will have 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 and 18. All are belongs to P block elements. Okay. And F block we have, right? F block. So these F block is contains two things, that is lanthanides and actinides. Lanthanides and actinides are considered under the F block. Sorry, here he called this group as a F block element. F block element. And see why he gave this different names here. See, so here what we have, S block elements are purely completely metals. They are purely metals here we have. These are light metals and they are metals itself. From this point, as we move here, as I reach here, the metallic nature starts decreasing here. So as here, if you see K is more metal, Calcium is less metal to this. Scandium is more less metal. Tellurium is more less. Vanadium is also. Chromium, manganese. They are less metallic in nature. The metallic nature starts decreasing. That's why he called this as a D block. Why? Because it is a transition block. Here, transition takes place. That is conversion of one state to another state. This starts slowly. What happens here? The conversion of characteristics are taking place here. That's why he called this block as a D block. And you can also call this block as a transition block. Transition elements, we can say. Even though these are metals, but we are going to see some changes in the characters. They lightly started moving towards the non-metallic character. And as they move over here, here we have found these elements. You can see the boron, silicon, this combination, different colored combination we have. These elements are metalloids. These elements are metalloids. Why? Because either they are not metals, they are not a non-metals. They are in the middle. And whatever the elements we have over here, they are non-metals, purely a non-metals. Okay, see here, if you start from here, initially you will start getting metals, later on you will start getting non-metal, radioactive elements you have started getting here, then you started getting non-metals, metalloids, then you started getting non-metals. That means, so from the third group, transition is taking place, that's why he called this tables, this block as a transition block. And he gave the name called as D block. Okay. Next important thing here. I hope you remember. Now you got the blocks and groups. Okay. Let's see. Next thing. We'll see about groups now. Individual groups. Now, so if you concentrate here, these two are light metals. They are light metals, you can say. They are lightweight metals. Their weight is very light. Lightweight metals. Here we have heavyweight metals. These are heavyweight metals, D block elements. These are lightweight metals, first point. So this is two groups we have. This is first S group. This is second S group. That's why 1S and 2S you are going to get. It is. And if you see here, these two are called as, these two what we have, we are going to get. Especially, let me see. I am not having space here. And I hope you understood. This is light metal. Yes, I will write it here. Light metal. All of these are. All of these, what we have, are light metals. Their weight is very less. And if you can see here, so this is 1s group, and this is 2s group. And if you see beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, okay, barium and radium. All of these are available. Actually, we are going to get these things in the crust of the earth. In the crust of the earth. So, these have got a name because they are available in crust, right? Because of that, they have got a name called as earth metals. Earth metals. Earth metals. But their nature we will see. Earth metals. And hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium, they are not available. They are not available in the crust of the earth. Okay, they are not got. But even they are also belongs to the same group. Okay, but so here 1s, I will write it here. 1s group element, that is hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium. Okay. Rubidium are called alkali metals. Alkali metals. And 2s group elements. 2s group elements are called as alkaline metals. Two s group metals are called as alkaline earth metals, you can call, because they are already told you why they call it earth metals. Okay, alkaline metals. Why these are 1s group elements are called as alkaline metals? Here, okay, when these metals we have, when these metals react with water, they form a strong base. They form a very strong base. They form a very strong base. What do you mean by base? The compound which has OH group. Let's say NaOH. So it is very strong base. Sodium, NaOH. Let's say LiOH twice. It is also very strong. LiOH, not twice. Okay, KOH, potassium hydroxide. These all are very strong bases, highly concentrated, highly strong bases. This, okay. So this group one element what we have, it forms when it reacts with water, it forms a strong base. That's why they have got name called as alkali metals, strong base. Whereas a 2s group what we have, it forms a weak bases. It forms a weak base. Let's say this magnesium, MgOH twice. It is weak compared to the, as the basic nature of MgOH is very weak compared to KOH. Okay, so they form a weak base. That's why they have been called as a alkaline earth metal. Alkaline metals forms weak bases. So group 2 elements forms weak bases when they react with water. That's why they are called as a alkaline metals. And first group elements, when they react with water, they form a strong bases. That's why they called as a alkali metals. Okay, I hope you understood. First group elements are clear. Second group, let's go to the, I'll come from here, 18th group. I hope you understood this, all of these things. And these are light metals, I told you. And here I already told you about D block. So I already told you D block is from 3 to 12. And I told you these are called as transition elements. Why these are called as transition elements? Because there is a transition of characters from metal to non-metal is taking place. Complete transition will take place. You will come to know about this transition when we start learning trends in modern periodic table. Okay, so as of now, that means transition, that is atomic radius, if you take the size of the atomic radius, if you take, so atomic radius, what happens? This starts increasing, starts decreasing. If you take nuclear charge, it will start decreasing, it will start increasing. So many things are there that will happen. Transition mainly starts from this phase. That's why they are called as transition metals. These are also metals. But these metals, I told you these are light metals. These both are light metals. And but these metals are heavy metals. Heavy metals. They are very weight. Their weight is very heavy. Their density is also very high. Heavy metals. That much is enough for the D block elements. And you can find here boron, silicon, germanium. This combination I will write separately. Boron, and they are also mentioned in a different color also here. You can see they have used different colors. See, boron, silicon, germanium, arsenic, antimony, tellurium, and polonium. Most poisonous element, polonium. These are called as metalloids. These all are called as metalloids. Metalloids means they have both the nature of metals as well as non-metals. You'll also study about this metals and non-metals in your class 10. Don't worry. Metals are highly ductile. Non-metals are not ductile. Metals are sonorous, means metals makes a sound. Non-metals will not make sound. So metals are malleable, non-metals are not malleable. Here, but metalloids, they have both the properties, non-metals. Okay, the metal here, the element which has both the metals and non. Sometime it shows metals property, sometime it shows non-metals property. That's why we call them as a metalloids. How many elements we have in the metalloids? See here, if you count this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 elements we have. Totally 7 metalloids we have here. After the metalloids, what we have here, these are all our non-metals. See here. So these all are light metals and these are heavy metals. Till here, this point. So here these are metalloids and these what we have. From this section, what we have, these all are purely non-metals. Purely non-metals. You should understand this. Okay, next we will see group 18 elements are called as inert gas. Inert gases. So, it has got different names. Inert gases, noble gases. And it has got one more, zeroth group element. Zeroth group element. Because the elements which belongs to 18th group, their outermost cell, there is no valence electron in the outermost. They have zero valence electron in the outermost cell. You will see this in upcoming part of this chapter. Okay, suppose helium is there. So, if you see the atomic structure of the helium, see this is the nucleus of the helium. The first cell, we have four cells, K, L, M, N. K cell can hold 2 electrons, L cell can hold 8 electrons, this can hold 16 electrons, this can hold 32 electrons. These are the capacity. Here, how many number of electrons are present? 2. So, we can see here. And its outermost cell, do you have any vacancy? Is it possible to add one more electron? Because it has only 2 places. It has only 2 places. Now it is completely filled. There is no empty space. So its valency. Valency means vacancy. Is there any vacancy of vacancy here? To add one more candidate here? No possible, right? It is completely. If this is a school, and if the school is having only 2, is going to have only 2 teachers, and all the 2, it has already 2 teachers. Is it going to recruit one more teacher? No, right? It is completely filled. There is no vacancy. So that this is zero. Like that, these all the elements have a zero valence group. That's why they have got a name called as zeroth group elements. Because they have a zero valency. In outer, they have a completely filled outermost cell. These guys have a completely filled outermost cell. Completely filled outermost cell. Okay, I hope you understood this. I hope you understood about 18th group. Let's see this. So next guys, you can see here, so 18th group is finished. Now here we have, these are called halogens. Halogens. Because these forms, when they react with the metals, let me write yes here, halogens. When they react with metal, they form halides. They form halides. That's why they are called as halogens. You watch this video one more time in the YouTube, okay? So if I start it from the starting point, again we are going to stop in the middle only. Okay, let's begin. Here halogens, 18th group elements are called as 0th group elements. Why? Because they have a zero valency. I explained about this already, and I explained about these things. You just go through my YouTube channel, your video in the YouTube. I'll just upload this same video over there. Okay. And next we will see halogens. 17th group elements are called as halogens. Why they are called halogens? Because when they react with the metals, they form halides. They form a halides. Here how many halogens we have? Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, astatine and UUS. So these all are going to be your 17th group elements and they are halogens. And these are all non-metals. Okay, so when these halogens, let's say if I have a chlorine, if it reacts with let's say magnesium, it produces a MgCl salt, magnesium chloride. Chloride means it's salt. Salt it is going to produce. So these are going to form salt formers. You can also call 17th group elements are called as salt formers. They form a salt when they react with metals, and you can also call them as a non-metals. They are completely non-metals. Here these all elements, these guys form a chloride. Then definitely the elements belongs to the 17th group, they form salts. That's why they got the name called as halogens. Halogens are those when they react with metals, they produce us salts. They produce us salts. Let's say here chlorine plus Mg, they are giving us, it is giving us MgCl, it is magnesium chloride salt. If it reacts with sodium, let's say Na plus Cl, if it reacts with it produces NaCl salt. Here NaCl is a salt, sodium chloride what we eat every day. Okay, if it reacts with potassium, let's say K potassium plus Cl, it gives us KCl, potassium chloride. The same kind of thing, if your fluorine reacts with bromine reacts with Mg, here you are going to get a Mg, it is MgCl2, it is MgBr2. It is MgBr only because it is having plus 2. You know, right? MgBr. It is a one kind of this salt. Okay, because of this, they form a salt. That's why they have got the name called as halogens. I hope you understood why we call 17th group elements are a halogens. 17th group elements are called as halogens because they form a salt. Okay, next we have 16th group elements. So these are called as 16th group elements we have, right? These are called as oxygen family, and these are called as the special name. I'll write it here. I don't have a space over there. So 16th group elements are called as chalcogens. Chalcogens, and you can also call them as a oxygen family. Oxygen family. You remember these names? These are very important. Chalcogens. Okay guys, and why these are called as chalcogens? Here I wrote, right? Because these what we have, oxygen and all of these things, oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium and polonium, radioactive element. So these actually they form a ores, and these things are present in the ore form, sulfide ore, you say. So it is available in the earth. Okay, when you magnesium sulfide, you are going to get when you dig the earth, and they are also available in the aluminium earth crust also. So they form ores actually. Okay, so because of these are the ore formers, because of that they have got the chalcogens. Here chalco means ore, the Greek term. So that's why they have got a chalcogen as the one more name, and another name is oxygen family. I hope you understood. Next we will go to the 15th group. Here these are nitrogens or nitrogen family. So 15th group elements, 15G, are called as nitrogens, and they are also called as nitrogen family elements. Nitrogen family elements. Okay, so yes, 16th here, N, P, A, S and this are nitrogens, and they are nitrogen family elements. Okay, because these are form carbonates like that, nitrate, those things. They are nitrogen family. These are only this much you remember. Then you have this 14th group is carbon family. Okay, and the 13th group is boron family. You can see boron family. This is how the introduction. Lanthanides, this is lanthanides, and this is about details of the groups. Next we will see what is the importance of the group name and period. Here if you see individual element, this is atomic number. He has given. This is atomic number. This is the symbol, and this what we have, it is a name, and this is atomic mass. In every table, atomic number, element, symbol, name, and atomic mass. Okay, and so mainly thing I wanted to say one thing. The term group refers to term group number refers to valence electron in the outermost shell. It gives valence electrons in the outermost shell of the elements. Group number refers to valence electrons in the outermost shell of their elements. Outermost shell of the elements. cell of the elements. See here, 18th group, I told you 0th group. This will have one valence electron. This will have two valence electron. This will have three valence electron. This will have four valence electron. This will have, we'll see from. So here one, group number one means, see guys, group number one means one valence electron. Group number two means two valence electron in their outermost cells. If it is outermost cell, two valence electron, one valency means we can add one electron here. Number of electrons in the outermost cell. Valence electron is nothing but number of electrons present in the outermost cell. Okay, valence electron is nothing but number of, valence electron means what? Number of electrons in the outermost cell. Number of electrons in the outermost. Here in this first group elements, what we have? First group means one valence electron. In all of these elements, lithium has one valence electron, say lithium. So this is lithium. It has three electrons. Let's say two electrons in the outermost cell. It has only one valence. See here, only one valence. If it is sodium, it is 11 atomic number. See, this is first cell can hold two. Second cell can hold eight electrons. 2 plus 8, 10. And we are left with the third cell. In the third cell, we have only one. 11 electrons were there. I have accommodated. See here. Like this, all of these elements have one valence electron. And all of these elements are having two valence electrons. If you see beryllium only. Lithium can hold two electrons. This cell is filled in the second cell here. Only two valence electrons in the outermost cell. Like that, this will have three electrons in the outermost cell. This will have four electrons in the outermost cell. This will, from the fifth point. So from the fifth till fourth, it is same. From fifth, what happens? Number of valence electron, it will be 8 minus 5. Again, it will have 3, 2, 1, like that. It goes out. Okay. So now group number refers to the valence electrons present in the outermost cell. From here, it will going to be 8, 10 minus 8, it gives you 2. Again, 3. Okay, like that. Here, 2. Group number. I will tell you how to identify these things. Group valence electrons in the this transition elements later. I hope you understood this much. Okay, let's see one more important point here. Periods. Period number will tell you this. I told you right, 1, 2, 3, how I told those cells, orbits. Orbits will be, the period will give you, the period number will give you number of cells present in the atomic structure of an element. Here first period element means only one cell. Here, so period represents, what we have period. So period represents, first period means one cell. Second period means two cells will be present. Two cells. Third period means three cells. So like that we have seven periods, right? Here in seventh period, we are going to have a seven cells, six cells, five cells, four cells, three cells, two cells, and one cell, like this. Okay, cell means hydrogen is having only one electron. This is hydrogen nucleus, only one electron. See, only one cell. Lithium is having two, right? It is also having two valence cells here. Lithium is having three electrons, right? First cell can hold two electrons, so the third cell, it has a two cells. Like that, sodium see here. So it is a nucleus of the sodium, two electrons, first cell, second cell, eight electrons, and the third cell here. Okay, 2 plus 8, 10, 10 plus 1, 11. See, it is 11. So if you see neon, it can have only two cells because it belongs to second group. See here, 2 and 8, 10, like that. Okay. So period refers, period number tells us number of cells present in a atomic structure of a element. I hope you understood this. Okay, now I will tell you the shortest, longest, last point of this modern periodic table. So many things are there. So for your syllabus, only this much is enough. And anyhow, we are going to study the trends in the modern periodic table. There I am going to discuss you all those things. Valence electrons, okay, valency, okay, atomic radius, nuclear charge, okay, then metallic character, non-metallic character, electron affinity, electronegativity. Those all are the characters we will discuss. First, I will write here all the periods. First period, second period, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh period. Here I will write seventh period like this. Here first period is very short period. See, only two members are there. In first period we have two members and it is very short period. Okay, in second period we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 element, 8 members. This is very short, I told you, and this is just a short period. And in third period also we have 8 elements and it is just a short period. You should remember number of elements presented. In fourth period, if you see, recalculate here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. See here, in fourth period, we have 18 elements. 18 elements. In fifth period, we have, see, in fifth period also, we have 18 elements. So, in 6th period, we have 32 elements. In 7th period also, we have 32 elements. If you see here, 18th. So, this is very short. First period is very short. So, second and third are short periods. And 4th and 5th. 4th and 5th are long period. 6th is the longest period. And seventh is continued one. It is not completed. It is continued period. It is continued. In this, while we are discussing about the periodicity, when I was explaining, I said 16, right? That is wrong. 18 elements are present in this period. I said that we started appearing properties every second elements. And after that, I said every eighth element. After that, I wrote 16 and 32. So, this 16 is wrong, it is 18 here. 18 elements are there. In 3 and 4, we have 3rd and 4th period, we have 18 elements. This is 3rd period and this 4th period, we have 18 elements. I hope you understood this. Let me write on the period systems. This is short period, very short. Very short. This is short. These two are long periods. Long, long. Longest here it is, longest, longest, and here we have, this is very long, you can take, sorry, this is also short, 1 minute, we are confused here, okay, here also we have long, very short, 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 it is also short. It is also short, see here, two shorts. One very short and two shorts. Short, long, long, longest, and continued one. It is not completed. It is discontinued cell. It is still continuing. If you find some more elements, we are going to add that. Here we have added lot of elements here. We have added lot of elements. And out of this, we have how many elements we have? Totally we have 118 elements. See here, our last element is 118 element. Totally we have 118 elements. Totally we have 118 elements. Out of them, 92 or 94 metals only we are going to have. अराउंड 92 एलिमेंट्स आर नॉन मेटल्स ओनली, सॉरी मेटल्स ओनली, अराउंड 92 एलिमेंट्स आर मेटल्स, रिमेनिंग आर नॉन मेटल्स एंड दिस कॉम्बिनेशन मेटलॉइड्स. टोटली वी हैव 118 एलिमेंट्स. ओके गाइस, सो टुडे विल स्टॉप हियर ओनली. ओके, सो वी हैव गॉट सम स्टक इन द क्लास, in between the class, so I am uploading this video to YouTube. Please go through there, go through my video YouTube channel and watch this video again. Okay, so we'll stop here only. So tomorrow we will discuss this one, trends in modern periodic table, which is the last part of this lesson.